Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Hong Kong and Philippines.
Hey, welcome back to the Asian Sevens Series here in Petaling Jaya in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Second leg, of course. First leg won by Hong Kong, and they're the team that feature in this first match of the last round of pool play. There they are in the red, Hong Kong, who won the leg, their home leg. And they're taking on the Philippines. Thanks for some of your tweets. Hashtag A7S. Blitzbocky.com calling in some results. Shad Nalim, who reckons Nigel Ratwati looks like Izzy Falau. And also Namantha Oshada as well. Thanks for your tweets, guys. As Alex McQueen gets us underway, usually he's there to pick up the kickoffs, but he's had to do the kicking duties himself this time. That probably means Jamie Hood's not in the field yet. Hoodie is not starting. So a free kick for the Philippines. These two teams played each other in pool play in Hong Kong, and Philippines went down 24-0. They are very amped up about doing well in this game. They need to get into the plate competition. Here's Tim Wahine from Papua New Guinea originally. Not releasing the ball carrier there, Coverdale. Here's the jeepney, Justin Coveney. Nice pass from Letts to Wolf. Andrew Wolf never looks like he's moving quickly. Glides, but boy, he's fast. Jake Letts again to Sean Lynch. Tries to go around the outside of Jones. Space here on the outside. Wahine cuts inside. This is good recycling. Now it's left for Jason Lynch, who cuts inside but is wrapped up nicely by Alex McQueen. In fact, McQueen trying to hold him up there for a minute, I think. It's been knocked on, so Kato Lee passes to Rowan Vaati. Jones to Alex McQueen, given more of a roving responsibility here, and that's why he's got some great pace and evasive skills. Lee with some great linking, and they won't stop the T-Mac. Round he goes for the first try of the game. A shame, Philippines on attack there, but really didn't have any pace out wide to exploit some of the numbers that they were getting. And then with a quick turnover, Tom McQueen with his first try of the tournament. The difference in hairstyles there, Alex with the more conservative one, and Tom with the extravagant head fashion. The Queen's really made a mess of that conversion, Alex, but they're 5-0 ahead. This is our last round of matches for today. It's when the first and second seeded teams play each other, so we're in for some good clashes. Sri Lanka will play China next. That'll be a good game. Evenly matched teams. Japan and Singapore, and South Korea, Malaysia. So three more good games after this one. Stay with us. Wahine gets ball and man at the same time. Sean Lynch again. Letts goes wide. Holgate. Pass it stretched Jason Lynch. Gets it to his brother. Coveney can't control football style. Not going to make the Axels with that sort of performance. It's gone backwards, and Philippines spring onto it. Nice work from Wolf. Coveney with the pink boots. Easy to pick him out today. Holgate. Jinks and jives. Dances. Little jink. Here's Jason Lynch. Now he's been held up. This is what Alex McQueen was trying to do before. So collapse more. And a Hong Kong scrum in a very handy position. midfield on the 22. Not what the Philippines would have wished for. Got two men on the left and one on the right. Kato Lee summing up his options. He's held up nicely by Letts though. Good strength from Letts. Lee eventually gets to ground. Sloppy ball, but it's Coverdale who picks it up nicely. Coveney wraps him up with a good tackle, but here's Tom McQueen outside and he's got Rowan Vaati. Slips around the outside of Lynch. Sean Lynch just couldn't drag him down, so Rowan Vaati gets the second try of this game. His fourth of the tournament, tying Jeong Yong Sik from Korea for highest try scorer. Turned into quite a cool afternoon here in Petaling Jaya. Down under 30 degrees now, a nice breeze blowing again. Oh, that's a beautiful kick from Alex McQueen. He's turned that one round. His second conversion of the tournament to go with a try. McQueen's parents in town as well, following the boys around. Left for Boheni. Went backwards, but oh, Kato Lee's got onto it, and oh, nice option from Lee. Very good option, and Jack Capon is the beneficiary of that. Lee looking left and right summed it up perfectly. Good distribution skills from Kato Lee, man from Kowloon. McQueen gets into double figures for the tournament and Hong Kong spring out to a 19 points to nil lead. Hard to put the finger on where Philippines are going wrong here. 24-0 in Hong Kong in the pool game, and already after 5 minutes they're down by 19 points. Maybe just need to make some headway over the advantage line. Commit themselves to running hard. It's been a lot of stopping and starting as Boheni gets a kickoff practice again. Takes this one with Andrew Wolf's hand in his face. Dangerous tackle there, but he's let down the ground nicely. And this is Wolf again, who really is a good mover. Tries to get the ball away to Coveney, but he was well wrapped up by Lee Jones, I think it was, back there. So again, Hong Kong with counter-attacking opportunities. Tom McQueen with all the pace in the world. He doesn't skirt around the outside. This time it's Holgate who goes in. Well, Holgate's been penalised. No room between the tackle and the release, says referee. That's half time. So Alex McQueen, who's becoming a wise old head in this squad, kicks it into touch. Good to see them resting Jamie Hood and giving Alex McQueen a chance to do some playmaking. So the score at half time is Hong Kong 19, Philippines 0. Gareth Baber. I'm not the only one. Certainly looks like Clive Owen, that British actor. I'm sure it's Clive Owen. He's acting as a rugby coach. He's doing a very good job too, isn't he? Hong Kong already showing rapid improvement. Of course, Baber arrived at the same time a lot of these players became full-time athletes, so little kick start there. Hope you're enjoying our coverage, streaming live on YouTube. Certainly a pleasure to bring it to you under the stand here at the Petaling Jaya Stadium. Here's Holgate, one of the fixtures of the Philippine squad the last few years. Had a spell in Japanese top league rugby too for Kyuden Voltex, the electricity company. It's a long kickoff to start the second half. Lee's underneath, gives it to Capon. He has the ball knocked out of his hands by Wolf. Oh, looks like we're playing punch ball here. Both ball carriers getting the ball punched out of their hands. So it's Tom McQueen who runs a sweet angle and then swerves around the outside of Holgate. Holgate's putting in some powerful work, trying to keep up, but he realizes that Tom McQueen's got too much of that gas in the tank, and all he can do is shepherd him into the corner. So second try for McQueen, and a good start for Hong Kong in the second half. So McQueen again gets the, Alex McQueen this time gets the chance to convert his brother's try. Tough kick. Hits it nicely though, just to the right. So 24 points to nil. Hong Kong lead the Philippines. That's a beautiful kick from McQueen. The only thing missing is, I guess, him running up 10 metres and catching his own kick. Maybe that's next season's plan. Nice handoff from Alex McQueen as well. Really playing a great role in this Hong Kong squad. Tsung Hin Hung is on, as is Woodward. Then swoops a nice little ball into Hin Hung. Kato Lee again. With the right options, got some good vision, Lee. McQueen gets a Sean Lynch in his mirror, but doesn't worry about that. Good work for Sean Lynch to get back to defuse that threat. And Tom McQueen even gasping for air. He must be running around a bit. Fit young man. So a replacement, it looks like Vati might be going off. Well, Hong Kong have let that bounce. That will be one thing that will be noted, I'm sure. Their strive for perfection. Wolf can't handle. Had a lot of defenders in his face. That must have been a little forward pass there from Lee to Capon, but they go on. And it's amazing how the team with dominance seems to get the run of the mill. Woodward, good young fixture, going for his Masters of Foreign Relations. And I'm sure tournaments like this will be good practice, interacting with all the people of Asia. Lee. Capon, who's proving to be a good link man. Alex McQueen, a danger man. And Dog, Kwok Kachun, a strong man. There's Capon again, who's found himself in the right place at the right time. And so is Max Woodward. Woodward with his first try of the tournament. and a 29-0 lead with a kick to come. One of Alex McQueen's easiest today. 29 turns into 31. So the top team in this pool, will face the second team in pool C, which at this stage will be Singapore. Wolf shapes to kick, but then out to Holgate. Here's Coveney. He draws two defenders, and the pass just floats between Boheny's hands, and he's very angry with himself and has every right to be. Coveney had done his job. Got the two defenders very interested in him. Boheny had 3 or 4 metres to work with if he'd caught the ball. Andrew Wolf looking a little worse for wear. And it's Kenny Stern coming on. I got the names right this time. The Philippines camp will be delighted with my performance. I hope they brought some San Miguel to share with all their buddies. Or even better, some Cerveza Negra, as Vincent Young goes on. Kato Lee. Here's Alex McQueen to Jack Kepom. A nice ball as he's falling. And Kwok Ka Chun looking for support as well. Squeezes. Good defensive rucking there from Kusha. Numbers here, but Kepom again just taking the tackle. Lee decides to probe the blind side. And the defense there. They're coming back for another penalty. Offside play, says ref. Kwok Ka Chung, big strong man, fireman. Well, this time it's Hong Kong that are penalised for holding on. Stevenson to Vincent Young, and now Boheny. He's certainly done some minutes today, Boheny. Stevenson from Cabramatta would like to be called a dual international now that he's played rugby league and rugby union for the Philippines, as have many of these players. Boheny. This time it's Jones from Canada, Vancouver. He's been held up, Jones, but he's done well. He's dropped the ball on the ground. Oh, they've caught it a knock-on. So Hong Kong, well, I thought Hong Kong may get another chance to score, but that'll be it for them. So Hong Kong with a resounding win of Pool A with a 31-0 victory over the Philippines. And that will relegate Philippines to the bowl competition tomorrow morning, which they're not going to be too happy about, you would imagine, coming here with high aspirations. And rightly so, a team stacked full of quality. But final score 31-0 to Hong Kong.